as I have read the first chapter of this storybook. So now I'm going to read part 2 of The Brave Little Tailor. Chapter number 2, The Brave Little Tailor, part 2. A ghost. The giant led the tailor to some large rocks. There a second giant was cooking a whole sheep over a fire. "Eat," he said. "I am a lucky man," thought the tailor. "Meat is even better than bread and jam." After dinner, the first giant showed the tailor a bed under one of the rocks. "You can sleep safely there." The bed was too big for the tailor. Quietly he got out and slept on the ground. Then in the middle of the night, the giant came back. He was carrying a great bar. He hit the bed with it. He broke the bed with one blow. "That killed the little man," he said. Early the next morning, the giants woke up. "I'm hungry," said one. "Let's go to the forest for food." Then noise woke the tailor. He followed them. "Good morning," he said cheerfully. The giants thought that the tailor was dead. "A ghost, a ghost," he screamed and ran away. "What's the matter?" "It's only me," the tailor called out, but they just ran faster. At the king's palace, the little tailor walked on into the world. He came to a king's palace. He was tired. He lay down on the grass outside. People saw him there asleep. They read 7 at one blow on his belt. "Great soldier," they said. "Let's tell the king." The king then asked the tailor to stay. "You are a brave man, I hear. You could help us," he said. "That's why I came," the tailor replied. He pointed at the words on his belt. "I can kill 7 at one blow." So the king made the tailor his chief soldier. But the other soldiers were frightened. "Perhaps he'll kill 7 of us at one blow," they said. They went to the king. "Sir," they said, "we are frightened of this man. If he doesn't leave, well, we will leave." The king was afraid. "I can't send the man away," he thought. He's so strong. He could kill me." Then he had an idea. "I need your help," the king told the tailor. "In the forest, there are 2 giants. They rob my people. They burn our homes. But soldiers can't stop them. Can you kill them for us? If you can, I'll give you half my land and you can marry my only daughter." "Half the king's land and a beautiful princess," thought the tailor. The little tailor smiled. He pointed at his belt. "I can kill 7 at one blow," he replied. "Those 2 giants will soon be dead." "Send 100 horsemen with you," said the king. "I won't need your horsemen," laughed the tailor. "Giant killer." The tailor and the 100 horsemen left the palace. They soon came to the forest. "Wait here," he told the horsemen. He ran into the forest and found the 2 giants asleep under a tree. The tailor filled his pockets with stones. He climbed up the tree and sat on a branch. Then he dropped a stone on one of the giants. "Why are you hitting me?" the giant asked the other giant. "I didn't hit you," replied the other. They went to sleep again. The tailor dropped a stone on the second giant. "No. Now you are hitting me," the giant said angrily. "No, I didn't do anything," said the first giant. "Yes, you did." "No, I didn't." They argued until they were tired. Then they lay down. The tailor chose the biggest stone in his pocket and threw it at the first giant. The giant jumped up. "So, you want to fight?" he shouted. He pushed the other giant against the tree. The second tree pushed him back. They started to fight. They pulled up trees by their roots and beat each other with them. The fight went on for a long time. At last, both giants fell down dead. The little tailor pulled his sword from his belt. He made a cut in each giant's body. Then he went back to the horsemen. "The giants are dead," he told them. They pulled up trees and fought be with them, but that was nothing. They didn't hurt me. I can kill someone at one blow. The horsemen rode into the forest. They saw the two giants dead on the ground. They rode back to the palace and told the king. The tailor then asked the king for his price. "So give me your daughter and your half land," he said.